In this video, Martin and I are going to talk about AI and answer the question, are we there yet?
And stick around to the end where Jeff and I will be explaining how we use AI in our everyday lives.
Hopefully you've seen some of my security videos on this channel.
Well, I sure have.
Well, great. And I've seen a lot of your AI videos as well. So we're going to have a conversation about AI. Are we there yet? Well, so I think we're kind of there because one definition of AI is basically the simulation of intelligent behavior in computers. And we've kind of done that. What do you think, Martin?
Yes, I would agree with that definition, but are we there yet? Absolutely not. I don't think so. And, okay. And the reason I think that is because of something called AGI, which is an acronym for Artificial General Intelligence. And this really describes an AI system that is equivalent to a human and is as diverse as a human and can do anything that a human can do at least as well or better. And I don't think we are there yet.
Okay, maybe not. So let's take a look at some examples of where we've come from and where we're going. So maybe a hypothetical.
Yeah, I've got a good one. I've got a good one. So let's just consider, I also write some numbers down here. Let's see this. If I put this up and then let's do 3, 1, 2, 5. If I could tell you in my head, just like that, the answer to that math equation, is that intelligence?
It's really impressive. It's a nice parlor trick. But you know, I've got a calculator that can do the same thing. And I'm really not ready to declare that my calculator is sentient. It's not artificially intelligent. So maybe not there yet, but it's a great example. Well, how about I'll tell you a story from in my middle school days. My science teacher considered intelligence would be if you knew all the elements in the periodic table, where they went, what their atomic numbers were, how to spell them and their abbreviations, and you could place all of that where it belonged. And that would have been considered intelligent. Was she right?
With the greatest respect to your science teacher, I don't think that's intelligence either. I think what you've just described there is a database lookup.
Yeah.
How about then something a bit more advanced than that? Something that takes years and years to get good at, like a chess grandmaster. Now think of all of the time that you have to invest to learn, all of the patterns, all of the moves, all of the strategy. Is a chess grandmaster a real example of intelligence?
Yeah, I think most people would say somebody who is the best in the world at chess is a genius. So you would think if you're a genius, you're intelligent. But guess what? IBM did this trick in 1997 where we created a computer we called Deep Blue, and Deep Blue was able to beat the best chess player in the world handily. Hmm. So that already, if that's your bar, we already passed it. Yet, again, we kind of feel like we're left empty. We're still not feeling there yet. So what is the classic question, the classic problem to solve?
You're going to tell me the Turing test, right?
I am going to tell you the Turing test. That's exactly right. And what is the Turing test for those who don't know? With a Turing test, you basically have a user here, and they cannot see who it is that they are typing to. So they're typing messages back and forth. And they may be talking to another person, or they may be talking to a computer. And if it's indistinguishable when they have their communications and they can't tell if they're talking to another person or talking to a computer, then we would declare game over. The computer has achieved artificial intelligence. So if we could ever do that, then we'd be there, right?
Well, this one is a little bit disputed as to have we passed the Turing test or not. But in 2014, technically, some people say that we did, with a chatbot that simulated a 13-year-old boy.
Well, so that's setting the bar kind of low. 13-year-old boy, you and I used to be one of those. So I think maybe we want to set the bar higher. But would we consider other technologies maybe that have raised the bar further towards the Turing test?
I mean, I talk with ChatGPT daily, and sometimes I could be convinced that is a real person. So I think, yeah, there have been a lot of advances in that kind of area.
I think so. I talk to ChatGPT regularly too. Nobody else will talk to me, so at least at least that one hasn't failed me yet. So that's a good example. Clearly, the bar has been raised. If we ask the question, are we there yet or not, I feel like it's a little bit like we move the finish line every time we get close to it. As soon as we cross it, then we say, yeah, but that's not quite there yet. So we kind of had this sense of, if you look at all of these things together, we have these sort of siloed savants. We have something that's really great at arithmetic. We have something that's really great at memorization and recall. something that's great at a narrowly bounded game that is quite complex, but still has very specific rules that can be mathematically described, or we're talking about a kind of general intelligence, emotional intelligence that would be required to pass the Turing test and things like that. So we continue to have these developments in individual areas, but putting it all together, that's your AGI.
But I think it's also worth pointing out that the development curve for AI, it just seems very recently, even this year, is just going faster and faster than ever before. And we are getting closer and closer to this idea of general intelligence, moving away from where we have everything siloed, like Deep Blue, which is deeply siloed to just chess, mm-hmm. to now these AI systems that are really getting closer and closer to being able to accomplish much more of what we do as humans.
I think you're right. When I was in school, we talked about artificial intelligence, and it was always about something that was about 5 or 10 years away. And then 10 years later, it was another 5 or 10 years away. But I feel like we're actually narrowing the gap. In the last few years, it's been this steep curve toward what we would consider general artificial intelligence. So, are we there yet?
No, but we've never been closer.
Awesome.
Hey, Jeff, we didn't get to the bit where you tell me how you're using AI in your everyday life.
I did forget that. So I actually have a self-driving car that brings me to work. It's basically a computer that takes me places. How about you? How do you use AI?
I realize that I'm not a very good photographer, but I'm much better at AI prompting. So I just prompt what I want in a picture, and it generates a beautiful professional photograph. It's fantastic.
Great. And I bet those watching this video don't realize that, in fact, you and I aren't here. All of this has been scripted by a chatbot. And we've been replaced.
How about you? How are you using AI in your everyday life? Let us know in the comments.